Welcome, everybody. I'm going to start 1 minute early. If that's okay with you, because some people might be hungry and have other places to go. But welcome to the Millikan Community Cello Choir concert in the spring semester. And thank you for sharing your people with me. It's been a pleasure to have them all semester. So I'm going to turn it over to them.
Hello everybody, I'm Rachel Gilbert. I am a senior child performance major here, also pursuing an entrepreneurship minor. And I am introducing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. We're playing three versions of it. So no one really knows who the composer of Twinkle Twinkle is. It started off as a poem written by Jane Taylor, who's an English poet. And then Mozart wrote some variations over it with the tune of a French folk melody written in the 1700s.
Thank you. started, so I have no idea. But it's just been an absolute delight in my life. I'm a musician by trade. Long ago, I was in college to become a music teacher, and I did that for a while. But I was a brass player. I am a brass player. Excuse me, no past tense in that. Now it's just been a delight to learn how to play cello, especially with this group. So we're going to play Scarborough Fair next. And Scarborough Fair is it was interesting looking this up because although I lived through the era when I got to hear Paul Simon and Art Garfunkel sing this on the radio, I never really knew what it was. It turns out it was a trade fair back in the Middle Ages. It was in Scarborough in Yorkshire, I want to say. But anyway, it was huge, and it lasted for like 45 days. And so this small trade fair, of course, grew and grew and grew, and it lasted for several hundred years until about the 18th century it died out. We're gonna do justice to this now with Scarborough Fair, arranged by Emma Butterworth.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Kevin Dow, and I'm a music pastor here in Decatur. I've lived here for 21 years now, I believe. I've been playing cello for only 3, so I've always wanted to play strings, but really didn't have the courage to try, and then I started a couple years ago, and I love it, so I'm really happy to be part of this group. Our next song, this song is special. It's dedicated tonight to a friend and a music colleague, Kent Winchester, and his family actually came tonight to hear us from the second row there, so thank you guys for coming. He loved music, and he especially loved bass parts, whether it be in singing or playing. If you knew him, you knew he loved a bass lead in a song, and so he would love this arrangement of this song. Some of my favorite memories as a kid, we're driving around town in a Jeep with my uncle. He drove my brother and I around, and the top was always off, and usually there was a Beach Boys cassette, I believe is what he used then, playing. So our next song is a Beach Boys song, and it was written in 1966, and there was over 90 hours, if that's interesting, 90 hours of studio recordings for that one track, and equivalent to today's dollars, it was over $400,000 for the one song, I believe they said, to produce that song. And Brian Wilson was one of the writers of the song, and the idea from the song came from when he was a little boy. He heard dogs barking really loud all the time, and he was scared of it, and his mom would say, it's okay. The dogs are just picking up on the vibes of the people, you know, if they like them or not, and then they bark really loud. And so he wrote this song based on the vibes, those vibes that you'd feel, like happy feelings you feel when you get to know somebody or just meeting someone, and you get those good vibes or those happy feels that you get when you first meet somebody. So tonight we'd like to share with you our version of the Beach Boys' Good Vibrations.
Arranged by Kevin.
Your house. is The Ash Grove. It's a Welsh folk tune. It has lyrics to it, and I would like to personally dedicate this one to my mother, who is watching, and to my father, who is in the hospital right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
song. If you know Suzuki books, it's a favorite. We also call it Cellist International Anthem.
Types of ensemble, especially one as unique as this with an instrument as beautiful as the cello is, so it's been a real treat. I get to introduce two pieces this evening, the Bohemian Folk Song, which fits our folk song narrative that we've been doing so far, where we had the French and Twinkle Twinkle earlier. Bohemian Folk Song has some interesting harmonies in it that we don't really see in the traditional German lexicon, so it's a nice breath of fresh air in that regard. We're going to end the concert with the theme from Symphony No. 1 by Brahms. Brahms followed Beethoven and was very nervous to be writing symphonies. He waited until the later part of his life, unlike most other composers of that era. And his very first symphony ends with a movement that is a tremendous nod to Beethoven's Symphony 9's last movement, the Ode to Joy. So it features a melody that really captures joy and the concept that if we keep moving forward, we will get to better things. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We hope you enjoy our two closing numbers. Thank you. Thank you.